Locally, we simply call our beautiful home the Valley. Of course, its correct long version of the nickname is the Valley of the Sun. But really, how did the Phoenix metro area get its nickname? Well, I'm going to tell you. But of course, I want to take care of a little bit of housekeeping. Let's not forget to click on the subscribe, hit that like button, and of course, ring the bell. You can always get a hold of me if you need any real estate needs, buying or selling here in the Phoenix Metro Valley, 480-734-8088. Email is ed@theheiserteam.com. So, how'd we get the name? Well, the Phoenix Metro area is built in the Salt River Valley. Wow. So, it wasn't much of a stretch in the 1920s for the locals to simply start calling and referring to their home as the Valley. Like LA and other metro areas, there's a ton of small, close-knit towns, cities. You don't even know when you drive from one to the next. You can go from Mesa to Tempe and you never know it. We just simply refer to it as the Valley of the Sun. We're basically located at 1,084 feet above sea level, and we're surrounded by a beautiful ring of mountains. That's what forms the valley. And most famously on the east side is the Superstition Mountains. It's known worldwide because, of course, of the Lost Dutchman gold mine and all the lore behind those beautiful and mystic mountains that form the east side of the valley. Tons of hiking trails. There's a neat kind of ghost town, western town village there that has a restaurant. Gold Canyon's located on that side. So there's a lot of things called Gold Canyon, etc., that reflects back on the gold mining days of the turn of the century. Swinging around to the southeast, one of my favorites is the Santan Mountain Range. And of course, it has the Santan Mountain Park. Tons of mountain biking and hiking trails. Love that area. It too had some gold mines, and there's two miners that are buried there near their old gold mine. Some of the trails will, you know, give descriptions of that area and those things there. Really kind of some neat history that goes along with all this area here in the valley. Swinging now to the west, we have South Mountain. That's kind of a geographical landmark, you know, because a lot of things there are called like South Mountain High School, South Mountain this, that, and the other. And then just to the west of that is a huge mountain range called the Sierra Estrellas. Really cool on the back of that mountain is a skydiving facility and an airport. We're kind of well known with our beautiful weather for skydiving. And down in Eloy, south of us, is also another huge worldwide well-known skydiving area as well. Now, really cool on the west side, next to Luke Air Force Base, is the White Tank Mountains. That forms our border on the west. And then swinging around to the north, the famous McDowell Mountains. Fort McDowell was a very famous, well-known fort in the western times, you know, around the late 1800s and turn of the century. Fort McDowell was a big happening place here in our history. And that forms that perfect bowl that makes the valley the valley. Now, what's really cool is running from the northeast to the southwest is the Salt River. It's kind of funny, a lot of people say, oh, there's no water, it's a desert. Well, we got two rivers. The Verde River runs from the north and converges to the Salt River just northeast of Mesa, right around Power Road when it turns right there at the river bottom. And that's where the fifth dam on the Salt is, the last dam that stops the Salt River and then directs all that water from the Salt River and the Verde Rivers into the valley proper through an incredibly awesome canal system that dates back to the Native Americans that lived here, you know, hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years. They had beautiful canal systems that we still use a lot of those even today. The Salt River, as I said, has five dams, but it forms four lakes or reservoirs, the largest being Roosevelt Lake, made by the Roosevelt Dam. The next is the longest and deepest lake in that chain, and that's the Apache Lake, and then is Canyon Lake, and then Saguaro Lake. Phoenix is the largest of some 30 cities that make up the Valley of the Sun. Now, what's really cool is in 1968, when Phoenix got its NBA basketball team, they, of course, wondered, what are we going to call it? Well, since it's the Phoenix NBA basketball team located in the Valley of the Sun, they named them the Phoenix Suns. Most people don't know why the Phoenix Suns are called the Suns, and simply because of the Valley of the Sun. So what's really cool is in the last year or two, the NBA has the city jerseys. And to give a little bit of history of the various hometowns, and you'll notice the Phoenix Suns has, of course, we're known for our beautiful sunsets. So they have a sunset with one of our scenic mountain ranges, and across it is the valley. Thus, the Phoenix Suns, named after the Valley of the Sun. And that is how we got our name, the Valley of the Sun. Now you know the rest of the story.